Dear friends, welcome again. Welcome again to our live broadcasting. I'm Alina Tomer and I'm a licensed tourist guide in Romania. I am a member of the Professional Tourist Guide Association ProGuide, and together with our colleagues and friends, we decided since we have been in lockdown since March to start this live, virtual guided tours. We have over 40 virtual tours in Romanian language, and this is the second virtual tour in English. We are over 300 members of licensed tourist guides or qualified tourist guides, and let's see what does it mean. It means to have such a certificate and such a badge. We have different kind of badges in Romania, but anyhow, each and every tourist guides, while he guide, he's enforced by law to wear such badge while doing the guiding. If you ever plan to come and visit Romania, or if you plan to organize a tour in Romania, please do use a licensed or qualified tourist guide. This is the one who's going to show you in the correct way the beauties of our country. You can find our details down here in the scrolling information, which is going to be all the time on while we are guiding. So let's invite next to us our friend and colleague, which is going to take us in a beautiful journey in Bucharest, again, the capital city of Romania. Hi, Florin, how are you?
Hi, I'm fine, thanks. Just like every Wednesday, I can say, except the last one. Sometimes it's not the way we want. I invite you to do a tour, this time in English. Since now I made another 8 tours in Romanian language, but I guess it's better in English because we want to have foreign tourists in Romania.
Of course. Do it.
First, I have to show you my my documents. I have it all the time with me when I'm with tourists. I had my first tour this Sunday in Bucharest, a short one, but it's a beginning for me after the lockdown.
That's
yeah, it's a good news.
Super.
For today, we talk about a beautiful building that is right in the center of Bucharest, Bucharest, Romanian capital. It's in Revolution Square. Here we have a map from Google Maps. You can find it is between Roman Square and University Square, so in, next to the old center. In front of the old Royal Palace, now is National Art Museum. And we have in the next next image also from Google Maps a view with the building and also the gardens that are in front of Romanian Athenaeum. Here in this place, we had a church built by Mihail Cantacuzino, the end of 17th century, and then the land became the property of equestrian society, Romanian. Christian society, so they wanted to build a circus, but they didn't have enough money, so The next project was a special building for culture, the Ateneum, Romanian Ateneum. That's why the building is like a dome, is round, because they wanted to build a circus here. Was built starting from 1886 until 1888. For us, for Romanians, is very famous. That's un leu pentru Ateneu. Everybody who wants to donate some money to give one Romanian leu for the Ateneu. The first one who donate money was King Carol I. And of course, the biggest amount donated for this this building. We have here a view from west part of the building. The entrance, the main entrance, is where you can see the columns. This entrance is used for the concerts. For visiting, is on the right side of the building. So you can visit this Romanian Ateneum. The price is 10 Romanian lei, but only when musicians are not inside to practice, or the moment when they have concert. So it should be empty to visit. That's why you have to call in advance or trust a guide who can guide it to you there. We can see here in front of the building six columns and another two on sides, so one on the left, one on the right, so we have eight columns. Then up we have 20 windows, and on the next image, yes, you can see here some names at every window: Michelangelo, Virgilio, Goethe, are 20. So for every window. You saw the columns. At the main entrance, we have also five portraits: King Carol I and two rulers of Valachia, two of Moldova. We have Alexandru cel Bun, we have Matei Basarab, I don't remember the other one, sorry. Usually I'm doing guided tours in front of the building, so it helped me a lot when I see the images. From these entrances, the main one, which is in front of the building, in west part of the building, or from south part of the building, in transport of tourists, we go to the ground floor of Romanian Ateneum. We have here 12 pilots, 12 apostles, and four staircases. On this four staircase, we can go up at the concert hall. Each of these four staircases have balconies at half distance. The staircases are covered with Carrara marble. In front of us, we can see also the main staircase for musicians that goes up to the stage. And on this staircase, we have the statue of George Enescu, our Mozart. This is a view from the balcony, from one of the staircases. We can see also the decorations from here. They used a lot of marble inside. And up at the first floor, we have the main concert hall. We have the building is 41 meters high, here we have an image with the stage. And up is written 1888, so the year when they finished the building of the Ateneum. The capacity of the Ateneum is almost 1,000 seats. But very important, inside the Athenaeum, we have a big fresco that is around the concert hall. The fresco should be done at the beginning of 20th century, so in 1901. They had this idea to paint most important episode of from our history, but they didn't have enough money for this, so they put on standby this project until 1933, when Cesar Petrescu decided to paint not directly on the wall, and this was a good luck, because if they did it at the beginning of 20th century, they didn't paint also the big unification from 1918, and also the last kings. We have also two images with the left side and the right side of the fresco. This is from when you stay on the stage is on the left side, but when you look at the stage is on the right hand. And on the other side, we have the rest of the fresco. So imagine a big painting around this hall, showing us Romanian history starting from 106. So we have 25 images, 25 paintings in one. And I will explain you some words of for each of them. So the first painting. Now we have first a portrait of Cesar Petrescu, the painter who did this big painting. Of course, he didn't work alone; had some other students, but it was his idea, his project, and he signed it at the end of the painting on the wall. So we have 25 paintings. The first one showed us the year 106, when the Romans conquered Dacia. Here where now is Romania was another country called Dacia. And in 106, Traian, the Roman emperor, standing here, looking the surroundings, happy to conquer the new territories. The Romans conquered Dacia, special for gold and silver. In this image, we have Traian, the Roman emperor, and also in the second plan, we have a bridge and some soldiers crossing Danube River on this bridge, the bridge built by Apollodor from Damascus. And also a Roman soldier with the Dacian symbol is that snake with the head of a wolf. In the second image, we have three different paintings. On the left side, we have some soldiers who come here in Dacia to live here. So it's the beginning of Romanian people. So starting from 106, we say start the process for Romanian people and Romanian language. Behind this Tropeum Traiani is a monument built in 106, between 106 and 109, special for Traian. In center of the image, we have a girl, a Dacian girl, who light a candle on a tomb of probably his father, her father, or her her husband killed during the war, and also a Roman soldier who show respect to this girl. So it's like girl, Dacian's girl made a new life with Roman soldiers. So it's just like I said, this process for Romanian people. On the right we have, please Alina, come back to this image, because we have the fourth painting is a soldier, a Roman soldier on a horse defending this territory. You can see the horse, it's very important, it's all with all four legs on the ground, showing us that this soldier is here to defend this territory. We go now forward to the next next slide of our presentation. The fifth one, after this, the Roman conquered Dacia, we have some other invasions of other migration population, especially from Asia. So people from here have to fight against invasions. The clouds here are painted with dark colors, gray, black, before the clouds are with blue. So this is the fifth episode. Then we have, after these invasions, in the next slide, we have another three parts of our history. The first one on the left, people coming back from the mountains here to work the fields with the bull, and they start also building churches and houses. You can see in the middle of this image, a structure is a future house. Also, Romanian peasants working, cutting the wood or making an arch to defend territories. And on the right, we have a soldier, a knight on the horse, coming here on these territories, and people who live here welcome him with bread and salt. It's something special for Romanians to offer salt and bread to our guests to show them their, they are welcome. In the next image, we have in center Mircea cel Bătrân, one of the rulers of Valahia. Behind is an image with Mănăstirea Cozia, Cozia Monastery, built by Mircea cel Bătrân, Mircea the Old. This is an episode we know very well from our from school, from Mihai Eminescu poem, Scrisoarea a treia, the third letter. Mihai Eminescu wrote about a virtual meeting between Mircea cel Bătrân and the Turks who come here to ask to Valachian ruler to pay the tribute to the Turks, but he said no. So this is a meeting between the Turks and Mircea cel Bătrân. In the next image, we have Alexandru cel Bun, one of the rulers of Moldova. Behind is Monastera, Moldovița Monastery, and here we have Alexandru cel Bun, the one who gave a sword to one of his soldiers, and also some documents to become owner of of land to have armies that that will defend the entire entire Moldavia. Next image, 11th one. Here we have Johannes Corvinus, Iancu de Hunedoara. I don't know if you know this information about him. He lived in Corvin's castle. Can be visited now, and I invite you to visit this castle. Anyways, behind Iancu de Hunedoara in this image, painted. Because he stopped in the 15th century, the Ottomans in Belgrade, in Catholic churches at 12 o'clock, ring the bells special for this moment. Every day at 12 o'clock, special for Iancu de Hunedoara. Next to Iancu de Hunedoara, we have Stefan II. The son of Alexandru cel Bun, and also Vlad Dracul, the father of Vlad the Impaler. Also here on the right, but is covered by ProGuide logo. Somehow behind is also Vlad the Impaler, Vlad Cepeș on the horse. The 12th. Thank you, Alina. Somehow there on the right is the face of Vlad Cepeș, Dracula. 12th, the 12th painting. In center of this painting, we have Stefan the Great, the greatest ruler of Moldova. He's riding his horse. Behind is Suceava Fortress, the capital during Stefan the Great, and he received the sword from the Pope. It was a title he received because he fought against Ottomans many times. Then we have the next image. Peace and faith. We have here. This is not my picture. All the pictures since now I take it from the Ateneo. Here we have Neagoi Basarab and his wife Despina in front of Curtea de Argeș Monastery, who was built by Neagoi Basarab. We have many stories here, including the myth of Manole. Once again, I invite you to come in Romania to visit this beautiful monastery. Now is the place where are the tombs of our kings and queens. In this church, the main church of the monastery, are buried Carol I and Elizabeth, Ferdinand and Mary, but Mary without the heart. In a new church, we have Carol II, Helen, and Michael and Queen Anne. Next image, we have Michael the Brave. Here in Alba Iulia, we talk about 1600, Michael the Brave unified for the first time Valachia, Moldova, and Transylvania, but only for a short time. This is another story. Maybe we have time in another presentation to explain this unification. He is very important for us because he made this dream of Romanians to live in only one country. For centuries we had Transylvania, we had Moldova and Valachia. Next image, we have the cultural era. We have here Matei Basarab and Vasile Lupu. Matei Basarab was the ruler of Valachia, Vasile Lupu ruler of Moldova. And Matei Basarab is important because he built 46 churches, one more than Stefan the Great. Behind we have Târgoviște fortress, painted, the church Treierarhi from Moldova, and Hurezu, the monastery from Oltenia. Also on the right we have Dimitrie Cantemir, who was ruler of Valachia, the one with blonde hair or white hair, at the desk writing something. And to the left of the image we have Constantin Brâncoveanu, and also the symbol of Cantacuzino family. That family came from the Byzantine Empire. We talk about the Cantacuzino family also in another presentation, Bușteni Castle, Cantacuzino Castle from Bușteni. Also, we have a painter there behind, to the right, between Dimitrie Cantemir and Constantin Brâncoveanu, is Pârfu Mutu, is the most famous painter of Brâncovenesc style of churches made in this Romanian style. Next image, we have two revolutions. One, Horea Cloșca and Tușan on the left, and in center of this image, we have Tudor Vladimirescu in 1821. Was a revolution, and behind we have an image of a kula. Kula is an Oltenian specific house from Oltenia. Then we have in the next two paintings, I guess are on the same image, yes, 1848. On the left is in Transylvania, and in center of this image, we have people who study in France coming back here in Valachia for this revolution. And we have the first, the image of first Romanian flag here, the one with the red, yellow, and blue, but horizontally, not vertically like now. So for the first time, our flag was with red, yellow, and blue, horizontal. Also on the right, we have the 20th image. We can see two girls working together. Because we talk about, maybe on the next image is better to see next three paintings. Yes, we have on the left two girls dressed in Romanian costumes. Working the wool, they represent Valachia and Moldova, because Alexandru Ioan Cuza, the one who is standing up with the red, with many decorations, and he made well, it was the first ruler of Romania. Romania, Moldova, and Valachia. So we have the unification from 1859 on 24th of January. Behind, on the left of Alexandru Ioan Cuza, we can see also Mihai Cogălnicianu. Then we have on the right, on the horse, riding the horse, is Carol the First, our first king, and somehow to the left, behind the horse, is Queen Elizabeth, dressed in white, killing some soldiers during the independence wars. So we talk about 1877. In that time, Carol was a prince of Romania, not a king. He became king after independence war. So this is the 22 part of this big painting. We can see also behind the king part of a bridge. Is Angel Salini Bridge over Danube, the one who helped the trains to cross the river going to Dobrogea, to Constanța, to the port. Constanța became Romanian territory after the independence war, so Alexandru Ioncuza unified Valahia, Moldova. Then Carol the First added Dobrogea to Romania from that moment. And now we go to the last two images. First, we have the First World War with soldiers fighting during the war. And now we have the last two images. Paintings with King Ferdinand and Queen Mary. So after the First World War, Romania became bigger, adding Transylvania and also another two parts of with Romanian people, Bukovina and Basarabia. We can see four girls. So on the left of this image, we have King Ferdinand and Queen Mary. This is the image when they became king and queen, king and queen of Big Romania in Alba Iulia. Behind is also General Berclau, who was very important during the First World War. And in the center of this image, we have four girls dressed in Romanian traditional costumes. Isumenia on the left, and then another three girls who became who represent Transylvania, Basarabia, and Bukovina. Another three territories who became Romanian, part of Big Romania during the King Ferdinand. And now we have on the right, the last painting and also the signature of Cezar Petrescu. But this last painting is not the original one. It's not the first one. It's original, but it's not the first one. Because in 1940, General Antonescu decided, asked Cezar Petrescu to replace this part. We have in the next image, in the next slide of our presentation, we have up the painting from now, and black and white is an image with the original one. You can see in the original one, King Ferdinand and Queen Mary, these four girls, and on the right we have King Carol II and King Michael. But just like I said, in 1940, Antonescu asked the painter to replace this painting with a new one, with some Romanians offering bread and salt to our guests, and a big Romanian flag. Now, Romanian Athenaeum looks very, very good during centuries, but we had also in 1944, when Bucharest was bombed by Germans, we have this image from after August 44. During time, the building was restored a few times. We talk about 60s, after the Communist Party came here in Romania, and after King Michael resigned, the Communist Party asked to cover this painting with some curtains red, because they didn't want to destroy it, but they didn't want it to leave it for the people. After the renovation from 1967, he decided to show us again this big fresco. Nobody from Communist Party said no. So since that moment, we can admire this big fresco. Now, this building belongs to Philharmonic George Enescu Philharmonic Orchestra from Romania. We have many concerts here, classical music concerts. We have the festival, George Enescu Festival, every 2 years. A decision from 2002 from Romanian government said that every 2 years we'll have a George Enescu Festival. Good luck for us, because it was last year, so in 2019. So anyway, in 2020, we don't have George Enescu Festival, but it will be next year. In September, for 3 weeks, concerts every day is one of the biggest festival for classic music from around the world. From here we can see, because this is the main entrance, just like I told you, from we can see the gardens, we can see also a statue of Mihai Eminescu, and these five portraits now I'm trying to remember. Vasile Lungu, Matei Pasarab, Carol the First, Alexandru cel Bun, and somebody else.
Anyhow, one more building not to be missed while you are in Bucharest. Mostly the tourists visiting Bucharest, they quite miss it, because they visit something else nearby, and it's a pity because it's a wonderful building, nevertheless represents, you know, the, let's say, the logo of Bucharest after the house of the parliament.
It's, usually I'm trying to go with my tourists. I told you I'm doing especially private tours, so it's easy for me to go with one or two tourists inside. I had also groups, big groups, 30, 40 tourists. Not so easy to go inside, to keep quiet inside. I told you it's the best acoustic in Romania, in this building. Usually, travel agencies that not include this visit inside the Athenaeum in their tours. We have the Village Museum, we have a stop here in Revolution Square just to see the balcony of Ceaușescu for the last time, to see the old Royal Palace, now National Art Museum, to explain what happened during the revolution from 1989, and also some information about the Athenaeum, but not to go inside, to spend 20 minutes at least inside to explain all this. Now I told you in, I don't know, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, I told you only some information. Of course, if I'm going there with some tourists, they ask, who is Nagoi Basarab, who is Michael the Brave? And then for me, it's more easy to go with somebody who asks something, not to speak by myself alone about something, because help me to tell more much more information about that building.
Okay.
Now I realize that I forgot to tell you about the organ who is there in behind the scene. Is the stage is from 1939 there, and George Ionescu donate a lot of money for this organ. So he helped the Philharmonic Orchestra to have an organ here in the Ateneum.
We have our concerts. Would you read it?
Good evening. It is good to attract foreigners to Bucharest after this pandemic. Of course, we try to have again foreign tourists in Romania, because I know that Romanians they don't ask for a guide when they go somewhere, because they said no, I can read myself everything, but the stories behind they have to search it on internet, and you know that as tour guides we study every day, we read every day new information, new stories about different places from Romania, so we can answer to almost all questions. I can hear you. No, it's not better.
Okay. Bye.
Okay, see you next Wednesday. Bye.
Dear friends, I hope you can hear me. Unfortunately, some technical problems, as not expected. I don't know what happened, but anyhow, I thank you
much for being with us today. And next Wednesday, we are going to meet again with Florin. I thank him very much for being today with us. I thank you very much for watching us. Please do not, let's say, forget, I would say, when you want to go and visit or come to visit Romania, just to employ on search for a qualified tourist guide, as this is the best one who can take you to the places and give you the proper information, as you can observe, as you could observe already from Florin's presentation. This is it for today. Today is Wednesday. Next live transmission, it's on Friday. We are going to visit Sinaia. We are leaving from Bucharest. We go to Sinaia to see another beautiful, let's say, part of history, of Romanian history. This is one of the most visited places while in Romania. We are talking about the beautiful Peleș Castle. And again, we'll have a tour in English. We have some comments here as well. Let's see. Olymp, nice presentation and true. A guided tour is always different, understand better than one without a guide. Yes, that's correct, Olymp. Thank you very much. Remind you once again, take a qualified tourist guide and enjoy Romania. And we are waiting for you. The things are starting to move, so don't forget and come to Romania. If you like us, just follow us Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube, and you can enjoy your Romania wherever you are. From us to you, all the best. See you Friday. Bye bye.